So I'm not in love with the spool holder on the Creality Ender 3. It's a bit small for the reel. So let's upgrade that, shall we? Yeah, I think we will, eh?
Hi guys, welcome to the channel. As you saw, the roll holder, spool holder on the Ender 3 type printers isn't quite up to scratch for my liking, and it's definitely harder to pull the filament through. So I downloaded a off of Thingiverse a spool holder ready made, and it's by a creator called Vilove. So we'll test this out. I'm going to go into here. Let's open up. This is the actual holder. If you want the same one, it takes some bearings. It's just normal skate bearings. Check quickly the... Okay, so it's given us some dimensions in millimeters. Let's just take a quick look. Read me.
Creality Ender 3 spool holder roller by Vilove on Thingiverse. Okay, no info. Okay.
Looks to be about right to me. That should be an 8mm kind of spline there that takes the bearing. Right, we got that part there. Now, get it all on the one build plate here. I'll go back in files. I want the stop. I'm gonna flop that in there. So you basically get two parts in the thing. Then you got the stop, you got this, and then I'm gonna clone number one. Oh, there we go. So you go into there, guys, clone, and you get yourself another one. Lovely jubbly. Go into layout here, I've never used. Okay, so we can have that kind of deal, or auto. Let's see what happens. I suppose that could work. Also, hold control and highlight all of those. I'm gonna go into my settings now, just have a quick look. We're gonna go for that. We're gonna go for wall line count, 2 is fine. Infill, we'll just pop that to 15, just to make sure. Infill line distance, 0.5. Infill lines, shouldn't need to be too much stronger than that, really. Speed, I'm on 100 at the minute. I suppose we'll keep that going as that. Support we don't need. It's all down on the flat sides, great. Back into there, material. Printing temperature 200. That's about right for my filament. 55 on the build plate with this black filament I've got. It likes it on 60. I'm gonna up to 205 actually on the heat. Yeah, build plate adhesion. We'll do a skirt. We'll do a skirt because it gets the filament flowing. So I always like to kind of let the skirt happen. We'll save that there, and we're good to go, guys. Quick and easy, three parts. We'll slice that. That's our preview, and then we'll save it into our normal folder. We'll go into there, lovely. I'm gonna copy that. I'm gonna go into this PC here, paste our sliced part in there. Okay, and then we're off to the printer, guys. So I'll pop this key in and we'll start printing. All right, and we'll see what it looks like in the end. See you in a bit. Okay guys, so that's finished printing. It seemed to come out okay, bar it lifted on one side on each of the parts. So let's put this off a little. It's come undone. Slipping off easy. You let it cool down, it's no problem. So you see one side lifted and it's become a bit thinner than the other side there, thicker. But the print actually came out pretty well. Nice and smooth. The prints are actually coming out very nice now. And I just forgot to wash the bed. I should have washed the bed one more time. But that's that part there. This is like the part that stops the spool from slipping. That came out perfect. It didn't leave the bed. A little V in it. But yeah, so you get two of these. Didn't take long, an hour to print that, just under. Of those, even one side slightly thinner because it left a bit, but it kind of re-stabilized, it re-leveled itself. And I've got my bearings here. That fits on there. It's a little bit loose, if anything. They're an 8mm interior and a 22 exterior.
I'll probably have to just put a little drop of CA glue on the very sort of spline to keep that bearing from slipping off, but otherwise it'll roll pretty well. So I've got two of those. So 8mm inside, 22 outside for the bearings, like a skateboard bearing, wheel bearing for a skateboard. And so let's install this and see how it all clips on, shall we? Okay, so drop a CA on the top of the spline. Bearings are on. I'm gonna clip this one. The clipping is very nice, I've got to say, the tolerance. Now, it could have a tendency to slip round a bit. And again, if it does, I'll use a bit of CA, but for now, I'm clipping on. Okay, they just go up the top there. And we get our spool, our reel, and we'll put that on there. And I'll go right to the back with it, I think. So if it does hit, it hits that back of that there. All right, it's on. Let's clip our little retainer on. That keeps it from coming forward. Okay, guys, it'll probably be good. It's better than it was. And now that smaller ring, let's go around this way. It's now more in the center of the reel. Yeah, it's not perfect, but it's pretty much in the center. And that's it, really. I'm gonna keep it there. I can print now. With that, it didn't have a big effect on the printing, you know, it didn't really have a massive effect on anything. It wants to twist for some reason, but once I get the filament through the, let's have a look, back through its guide there, and then back down into the extruder, that'll be fine. Just a little bit less resistance for it to spin that round. So there you go, guys, upgraded spool holder. Printed by V-Love, and I can always do another one day if this doesn't work out, but it seems fine. So join me on the next video, guys, coming up. Not sure what that is yet, but we'll see. It'll be more of this kind of thing. So hit the buttons. Nice to see you. See you nice. See you on the next one, guys. Cheers. Bye.